Hi, welcome to the series of Jasper Reports. In this video, we are going to see the basics of bands, data source connections, and properties of a report. The agenda for this session is, firstly, I will walk you through about the basics of bands and their usage. Secondly, we take a look at the list of data sources available, and we will see how we can connect to a data source called PubMart, which is running on PostgreSQL server. Then we will discuss about the properties of a report. And finally, we will create our first grid-like report using column and detail bands. So let's get started. Bands and their usage. The report editing area is a multi-tabbed environment in the studio. Basically, there are three tabs in the editing area. They include design tab, source tab, and final one is the preview tab. Bands come under the design tab. Bands specify the building blocks of a report design. Every band has its own height and width. A band width is as wide as the report width or as the page width. This includes the right and left margins width. And the summation of all the bands' height should be less than or equal to the height excluding the top and bottom margin heights. We can categorize bands into three types. They include predefined bands, invisible bands, and custom bands. Let's briefly look at these band types. To start with, predefined bands. Every report that we create by default gets 7 predefined bands. They include title band, page header band, column header band, detail band, column footer band, page footer band, and the summary band. Let's briefly look at each of these bands. Title band. Title band is the first visible band on the design view. In this band, we generally give titles for a report. We can print the title of a report on a new page. For that, we have to select the checkbox option called Title on a New Page from the Properties of the Report under the Report module. Page Header Band. The Page Header Band allows us to define a page header. The height specified for the Page Header Band during the design phase usually does not change during the report creation process. That means it is a static band. The page header appears on all printed pages in the position defined during the design phase. Title and summary bands do not include the page header when printed on a separate page. Column header band. In the column header band, we generally keep the labels for each detail column. For instance, we include labels such as product ID, product name, and many more in a product detail report using static text fields. Detail band. Detail band is the core band for any grid-like report. This band will be printed for each of the elements in the data source. That means the details will be printed as many times as the number of rows that a result set has. We can use more than one detail band in a report, but the best practice is to avoid having multiple detail bands. Instead, we can have sub-reports as a performance factor. Column footer band. This band appears at the end of each column. We generally use this band to keep the summations of columns. In the report properties, we can select the option called float column footer. This option brings up the summation that we keep in the column footer just beneath the end of the rows. The column footer band is also a static band. That means this band cannot grow with the elements. It is fixed. Page footer band. The page footer band appears at the end of the each page. We usually use this band to print the page numbers. Like column footer band, we cannot resize this band, so we avoid keeping elements such as charts or tables in this band. Summary band. In the summary band, we specify the summary information of the reports. In this band, we generally keep KPIs, key performance indicators of the report, or graphical information, or grid-like summaries using crosstabs. This is one of the most commonly used bands for the summary reports. Now, let's move on to the invisible bands. We can consider last page footer, no data band, background bands as invisible bands. When we create a report, these bands by default invisible, but these are very useful in the report creation process. Let's have a look at these bands. Last page footer band. We can print the report footer in a special band called last page footer. If the band height is zero, it is completely ignored, and the layout established for the common page is used for the last page. No data band. It's cumbersome to have nothing on the report output for a specific selection of the parameters. In those cases, we can use the no data band to display some custom message to the user. Background band. We generally use this band to have watermarks for the reports. Now let's move on to the custom bands. We can consider group header and group footer are the custom bands for a report. Users can group the report data by a specific field. For instance, in a product detail report, a user might want to group the data based on its brand name. So to represent the group of data, we create group by bands. Group by bands can have group header and group footer. Generally, in the group header, we display the group field name, and in the footer, we display the group level summation. So that's about the bands in the Jaspersoft Design Studio. Now let's move on to the data sources. Data sources start with the data adapters concept in Jasper reports. Data adapters. A data adapter is an XML file in the studio. It contains the information about where our data is located. The information includes URL for the database server, username, password, and any additional parameters that can be used by the data source connection. A data adapter does not contain any data itself. The data is located in the JR data source internally. We can import and export the data adapter as an XML file. Jaspersoft connects to a variety of data sources. They include JDBC connection, Java Bean collection data source, XML data source, CSV data source, Hibernate connection, Hadoop Hive data source, and many more. For this demo, we are going to connect to Foodman database, which is running on PostgreSQL server. That means we are going to make a JDBC connection. For that, we need to be in the repository explorer view of the studio. So in the studio, we need to be in the repository explorer. And this has got two sections here, data adapters and servers. We need to be in the data adapters. Right click on this one, then click on create data adapter. And from the list of available data adapters, select the database JDBC connection and then click on next. In the connection wizard, let us provide all the entries to make a connection to a database. So in this demonstration, we are going to connect to PostgreSQL Server. From the JDBC dropdown, select the PostgreSQL driver. So we can identify PostgreSQL Server by or PostgreSQL, then the driver. As we select the driver, it populates with the URL, and we need to provide the information about the host and the database. I am going to connect Foodmod database, which is running on PostgreSQL Server in my local instance. So I am not going to change this local host, and I am going to keep as it is. So I am going to change the database as Foodmod here. And the default username and password for Foodmod is Postgres and Postgres. So let's provide the username and password. Now, before we make a test to the connection, let's have a look at the other options for the data sources. In the bottom menu, click on the connection properties. Here, we can see here we can specify any additional parameters that the database uses. We can also specify other advanced options such as auto commit and read only. In the case of MS SQL database server, we get a lot of properties, and we provide those properties in this section. Now the other tab indicates about the driver class path. If a driver is not available in the list of specified drivers from the JDBC dropdown, we can explicitly download and point them from this section. So now let's click on the test button here. We can see that the connection has passed. So click on the next or finish to have the data adapter created. So next, then database location, then click on finish. We can see the data source connection is created as new data adapter. We can edit the connections as we create. So right click on the created connection and then click on the data adapter. Let's rename this as Foodmod database. Foodmod. So now we have the Foodmod data source connection created in the adapter section, in the data adapter section. So we can duplicate a data adapter, or we can delete the data adapter by clicking on the delete option. We can export this data source connection as an XML file, and we can have the exported file to be imported if we install JasperSoft in another instance. Now let us move on to the creating first report and looking at the properties of a report for that. So let's go back to the PPT. Then let's have a look at the report properties. Create a blank report from the studio. File, new, Jasper report. Then select the blank input from the report templates. Then click on next. And let's save this report as first report product detail report. I am going to save under reports folder of Jasper Reports 2021 with the first report as the name. So click on next. And from the data adapter dropdown, let us select the Foodman database that we just created. Let's query the product table with product ID, product name, brand name, gross weight, and net weight fields. So I am going to copy the SQL from the PG admin tool to the editor of the SQL, editor of the studio. So click on next. Let us push all the data set fields from the left side wizard to the right side wizard here. So click on next. Let's skip group by for this report now. So click on next and then click on finish. As we click on finish, we can see the report editing area in the middle of the tool. So by default, this contains 7 bands. We can see them as title band, page header band, column header band, detail band, column footer band, page footer band, and the summary band. So before we design the grid-like report, let's have a look at the report properties. From the outline view, select the report name, which is the root node here. And as soon as we select the root node, we can see the properties are highlighted on the properties view here. So the basic properties includes for report are report name, description, language, and there are a few other options that we can perform on the report. So coming to the language property, Jaspersoft supports 3 different types of languages. They include Java, JavaScript, and Groovy. The widely used reporting language is Java, and all our examples will be based on it. Now, one other important property for a report is when no data type. This property is useful for what to print when there are no records written from the data set. By default, the option is null, but we can choose no pages, blank pages, all sections, no detail band, and no data section from this dropdown. And the other important properties associated with the report is page format. This section majorly specifies the report width and height. So click on this edit page format or double click on this page icon. So click on edit page format. We can see that we can see the report format page here. Jaspersoft supports report units in pixels, centimeters, millimeters, and in inches. The widely used property is pixels, this one. And the default format for any report is A4, but we can select from this dropdown as the A5, A6, or basically it depends on the report requirement. The default page orientation for any report is portrait, but we can switch to landscape. We need to ensure that the same unit is used across the report development. For example, if we choose pixels here, we need to make sure that everywhere we use the pixels. Similarly, if we go with centimeters or millimeters, we need to ensure that the same units are used across the report development. So I am going to make it default, which is pixels here. Margins. By default, every report that we create gets a default of 20 pixels margins at top, bottom, left, and right of the report. Now, column property. We can divide the report into more than one column. By default, every report that we create is based on one column. Columns are basically used to export the data horizontally, like a growing crosstab. We can also provide the space between columns. The default print order for a report is vertical, but if we want to export the data as a growing tab, we can select this as vertical to horizontal. Now, let us create the first grid-like report using column and detail band. For that, select the root node from the outline, then expand the field nodes. Let's drag and drop the product ID, product name, gross weight, and net weight fields to the detail band. Okay, let's reselect and drag them again onto the detail band. Let's remove the empty spaces by double clicking on any space on any area of the band. So let's give a title to the report by dragging a text field from the palette, and let's name the report as first report product detail. So adjust the width of the text field element, and in the double quotes, let's give the report name. Now in the page header band, let's keep some information, like let's give some description in this text field. This will print on each page header. So this report indicates the product details. So this text will be repeated on each page header. Now in the column footer, we generally use this to keep the summations of each column. So to have the net weight field summation for each column, we can add a variable to the column footer band here. So the easiest way to add a variable for column footer is select the target field and drag it onto the column footer band here. So in the list of available function, let us select the sum and then click on OK and position this variable in the column footer band. In the page footer band, we generally keep the page numbers. For that, in the palette section, we have the composite elements, which is based on more than one reporting object. So let us take page X of Y object. So let's drag this onto the page footer band. In the summary band, we provide summary information of this report. So for that, let's take a summary information by creating a chart. So I am selecting the default charts here based on JFree technology. I am going to select the bar chart here and click on next. And we will discuss about these charts in detail in future sessions. But for this demonstration purposes, let us go with the summary information from the bar chart. So the default series is selected. So let's provide the value from the net weight field. and let categorize this product information by its brand name. Then click on finish. Then in the data set, let us go with the main data set. We are not dealing with any data sets, any sub data sets in this report. So let's go with the main data set. So click on finish. In this demonstration, we are trying to work with every possible detail when we create a report. So we have the title given. Let's increase the font size a bit more and position it to horizontally and vertically middle. And let's take the label for the column footer. So total net weight by column. So let's make this report to look like a grid by giving borders to each of the text elements. For that, we can multi-select all the elements, then go to the common properties, then switch to the borders section, then click on the all borders here. And let's position all these elements vertically middle and the horizontally middle. Let's bold the labels for better look and feel. Increase the font size a bit more. So 12 looks good. And this is the page header. This should be repeated in every page. So we can make this column footer band to float with the result of the report. For that, select the column footer from the outline view. So we have selected the column footer, not the column footer exactly. Select the report name, then go to the properties of this report. Then we can select this option called float column footer. So as we select this one, we can see the summation of this column is appended with the result set of the page. That means, for example, if we get output in off of the page, the summation will get immediately after the last row. So it will not be printed at the end of the page. It appends with the last row of the record. So let's look at the output by clicking on the preview button. So in the bottom, we have the preview button, and let's run this report. We can see that the output is of three pages. So this is the title of the report. This indicates the page header text, and these are the column headers. Basically, these are the labels given in the column header band, and these are the details of the report. And in the bottom, we can see that column level summation as the 215 here. And in the page footer, we have given the page numbers. It displays page 1 of 3. So moving on to the next page, we can see that the page header is repeated, the column headers are repeated, and we can see the column summation varies from the previous page summation. So we can see that this has 214, but in the previous page, this is 215. So this clearly shows that the summations will be based on the particular column in each page. So moving on to the final page, we can see the summary information of the products. Now, let's look at the other bands that we can apply on this report. So we have lost page footer, no data band, and we can also create custom bands, which we call it as group by bands. So in this demonstration, let us see how we can work with last page footer. We will see about this no data or background band or the group by bands in separate sessions. So let's go with this band for this demo. So right click on this band, then click on add band. This particular band prints at the last page of the report. For example, I am going to keep some text. I am going to keep some text in this last page footer band, and this should not be repeated in each of the page. Instead, it will display at the end of the report page. So I am going to add some custom text like this is last page footer band. This is last page footer text. So when we run the report, we should be able to see this message in the last page of the report output, but we shouldn't see this message in the first page or the second page or in the other pages. So let's remove the empty spaces and let's preview the report again. In the first page, we can see the details of the report with its title, then the page header, then the column labels, then the details and column level summation, page footer information. We don't see the text that we just gave in the last page footer band. So we should be able to see that in the third page of the report. So let's directly jump onto the third page. So in the bottom, okay. So in the second page, do we see that? This is last page footer text. So this indicates that this is the last page of the report. So the summary will always displace after the page footer bands. So this brings us to the end of the session on bands, data source connections, and properties of a report. So before we wrap up, let's do a quick recap of what we saw in this session. So going back to the PPT. So before we do a quick recap, let's do a QA on this session. So can a report have more than one detail band? Yes, a report can have more than one detail band, but it is not recommended because we will see performance factors when we run the report having multiple detail bands. So the recap for this session is, firstly, I walked you through about the bands and their usage. Secondly, we took a look at the list of data sources available, and we saw how we can connect to the PubMed database that is running on PostgreSQL server. Then we discussed about the properties of a report in detail. And finally, we have seen our first grid-like report using column and detail bands. So that's all for this video. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for more updates.